Okay, hair and makeup is done. You guys, I've had a hair trauma. Like, it kind of looks okay now. Sorry, it's a little bit dark. Oh, this is better right here. There we go. It kind of looks a little bit dark, but I curled the whole head, and I used, like, a medium-sized barrel, and by the time I got to this whole side was, like, dropped, and it just looked horrible. So I had to recurl it, and this is, like, crunchy and hard. I put so much hairspray in it. It's disgusting. But do y'all like my makeup, though? So yeah, now I'm about to do Imani's makeup. Corey's just standing like that.
Yeah, she is. Well,
this is... Okay. But yeah, this is before. Get real close. Yeah.
Oh gosh, like that was such an ugly angle.
Okay guys, so I'm all ready. Trying to keep the girls in tonight. This is the crew. Look at us trying to walk down the steps. Look at them in nude. You guys are so cute. You have to take a BFF picture today. And I'll just be in the middle like.
Oh!
on.
And Lil Wayne Slap.
Oh!
girl you dream about and want to wake up with. One time for the illest queen alive and the realest one around. Rich in confidence while working from 9 to 5. Always, always staying fly. No one notices the struggle. No one notices the plight or what it's like being the illest around. Flawless and brown, but also ambitious. The ambitious girl with drive that drives them crazy. I'm trying to get him to stay with me, lay with me, pray with me since I'm not intuition. I'm looking for someone to love me for my aspirations. You see, the last...
For you are mine, and where? Okay.
See, I remember the time my ex's mother told me I didn't know how I would react when I brought home a black girl. But I like you because you talk so white. But since when did me talking white equate to me talking white? They say you're not the average black girl. No, I'm not the average black girl because the melanin in my skin is just the shade lighting that black girl over there. You know that black girl over there, that black girl with the nappy hair, that black girl whose elbows can't keep a day without lotion.
Oh, wow.
Whose black hands are filled up with self-hating bottles of lotion. The cocoa brown girls look big tonight every day being tough because no matter how good they straighten their hair, they're going to still not enough. But luckily for me, I don't fall into that category, you see, because I speak with so much class, have just a little but not too much ass, have just a little but not too much fat, you know, just a little bit of attitude. Because I hate to come off as one of those average black girls that come off as rude, you know, popping their gum and shaking their neck, because those black girls get like no respect. But luckily for me, see, I get a pass because the melanin in my skin matches that brown paper bag. My father, brother, men that I date, pants don't sag. When I speak, my tongue pronounces every syllable. The comb part of my hair is naturally invisible. Oh, it must be weave. Oh, she must be mixed because the average black girl ain't got that good. They say I'm not the average black girl because I corrected the professor when he used the word conversate. Converse. The word is converse. And in case you haven't gotten it all, they're now 8, not 9 cents in the universe. And when you're watching the numbers and your stock prices rise up and down, think of a small town in Oklahoma, one of the first Wall Street people, the Black Wall Street, got mysteriously burned down. But the strip of the lines can blur over time because the average black girl I know? The average black girl I know made 19 trips through the Underground Railroad to free the slaves.
Yes!
That once segregated bus refused to move and paved new ways. You see, the average black girl I know? The average black girl I know were Egyptian queens like Hatshepsut and Neo Chris, ruling those dynasties and armies that meant, excuse me, as I set fire to this pole with my pen because I am tired. Tired of the stereotypes black women fall into due to white American mentality.
Come on, Ted.
So part of me, I can't openly accept your compliments. Part of me, I can't openly accept your compliments. It's just the average black girl that I know. The average black girl that I know had courage. They surpassed every fear, fought for justice and equality year after year. So I can show these words. Excuse me, I'm not shedding tears. I'm just not half the black girl she was. I'm not half the black girl she was. So I bow down to my queen, standing in the merit of their work. And as society continues to throw these supercilious words unto me, I say no. I'm not the average black girl. I can only aspire to this.
Yes!
My dad is God trouble the
Maybe Tibbs and Sabrina Fulton and Wanda Johnson black, so black I'm afraid to make a son. Your mama black. Say it to my face, he thinks she grown black. Body grew up before she did. All my babies born dead black. Everybody, my auntie black, born play cousins, and I got teeth in my mouth, and I got prayer in my throat.
Keep moving money, keep going slave, that's the
Okay. Okay. See, mom. So when you didn't return any of the 14 phone calls I made to you in the last 15 minutes, okay, I grew a little worried. I called all three hospitals in a 25-mile radius from your place of employment to make sure you weren't brought in with the amnesia and needed a friend. I also gave a phone call to your mom. She's a bit worried about it. She may want to call her back. No need to thank me. While you're at work today, I took the liberty of organizing all the toiletries you keep in the bathroom. Went to the store and bought those same toiletries and travel size for my place. Would have bought the regular size ones, but I didn't want to be too presumptuous. I know how you get when I mention commitment. So this is me not being clingy. This is me with no strings attached. This is me just having fun, just like you want. I want what you want. We are so perfect for each other. In a non-committed, non-clingy sort of way, of course. Today I cooked your favorite meal. Actually, all of your favorite meals. So if you're not feeling this one, I could take one down, pop it in the microwave, make it again from scratch, whatever you prefer, because I'm here for you. You know, I went ring shopping the other day.
Crazy, what?
After picking a look at your W-2 and bank statement, I feel as though I found the perfect one in your price range. Of course, I mean, we're not even boyfriend and girlfriend yet, and even though I have her number memorized, you still haven't taken me to meet your mama yet. Crazy, what? The situation, not me, because I'm not crazy. I am goal-oriented and focused and detailed and maybe just a tad bit clingy, but it's only because you're so right for me, and I've studied you. So now, I'm so right for you. It's crazy to think what my life was like before you, therapy sessions, restraining order, but there are bright days ahead because I know that you've come to determine the fact that I need to be committed in a relationship, not hospital. Try that, hang it in, because I'm not crazy. I'm crazy for you.
Tell mommy you're not.
So, starting off with Miss Purple and Gold, we have Miss Chantal Canicle. Bloody Side, we have Miss Tyra Walker. For Miss Miss 1921, Miss Lauren Winston. Miss 1911, Miss Taylor Stewart. Miss Omega Psi Phi is Miss